but they were committed. They were not faithful in their walk with the Lord. And so their placement was far, far back. So where will your placement be in the family of God? He's a family. And there are many places in that family. And there's many placements for you and I. Now, I spoke about so I'm going to quit. But I want to give you an opportunity this morning that how do you recognize your life before God? I would be the first one to come down to this altar because I need more of God. I need more of God. And I've tried my best to serve Him with all my heart. But there's always room for more. And I would ask you this morning here, do you recognize perhaps you have been your salvation is not a burden, put it this way, not in the front burner, but your salvation is maybe in the back burner. Dedicated more of your time to those things which are temporal rather than those things which are eternal. And is this not a call for sinners? A call for Christians. If you recognize I need to give more time to the eternal than the temporal. It's not a condemnation, it's just a desire in your heart. And if you have that desire in your heart, can we just stand before the Lord and present ourselves to Him? Jesus. Lord, I would give my life to the eternal. May the temporal go dim. And if you'd like to just lift your hands before God and express this with all of your other heart and your own voice, tell Him, Lord, cause me to see the eternal. Cause me to see the eternal and make it my priority. I want you to talk to the Lord at your own lips. I don't have to hear you, but I want you to talk to the Lord. And tell them, most of you are understanding. So tell them in your heart what you want. Say, God, hear mine. I yield to you that you would build my life to be a spiritual house. To be a spiritual house with my priority. So I pray, Lord, that you look upon those who raise their hands. Those who, with their spirits crying out to you, Lord, that we would be more eternal minded. That we would allow you to make ourselves to grow. We would not be found as that low one in the summer star, not being developed, not being mature. That I would cry out, O God, to you with your lives. For I am obedience to you. Because it's by obedience to your word that you found us in God, producing these materials. So, Father, I bless the church and the people this morning. Cause that, of course, Lord, we're all guilty. We're all so consumed with everything around us. We ask you to forgive us. Lord, may our eyes be wide open to the truth. Lord, may our eyes be open to see you return in the foolishness of the present. Oh God, we bless you. Thank you, Jesus. Now I want to just pray here a moment, and I'll ask everyone just to pray. But you know, perhaps there's someone here this morning. You never even started with the right road. It begins by being born again. It begins by giving your life, turning your life to Jesus. Perhaps you might have been in church all your life. I don't know. And never been born again. But I want to give you an opportunity because eternity is very serious. It's a very serious matter, eternity. And I want to give you an opportunity. If you're not born again, you don't know Jesus as your Savior. I remember years ago, I was pastoring a Christian church. young girl, 17, 18, in the church. We were going to have a baptismal service. So I met with those who have been baptized, and so I asked each one. And this girl, I said, Virginia, when did you give your life to Jesus? She says, oh, Pastor, I grew up in a Christian family. I've been coming to church all my life. I said, for the same time, Virginia, when did you give your life to Jesus? She says, oh, I love to sing the songs of the church. And she was a beautiful singer. And I said, the third time, Virginia, when did you give your life to Jesus? And by that time, tears were coming down her eyes. She realized she'd been in church all of her life. But singing all the songs in the church was never born again. And I find many people like that. You think because you're just in church or in school, there must be one of the truths. If you were here this morning, you know you're not ready to meet God. If Jesus would come today, something would happen, if you would die today, where would you go? Where would you go? Would your spirit go to eternity? Is your spirit being born again? Receive the salvation through Jesus Christ? And I want to give you that opportunity. If you know you're not right with God, you'd like to make it right this morning, just lift your hand. Just lift your hand. If you know you're not right with God this morning, but would like to make it right, just do it right now. There's a horrible thing. You'll leave eternity to not knowing Jesus. So Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you. Thank you, Lord, for the privilege of presenting your word. I pray, oh God, that you would give us a vision. Help us to understand that we would yield our lives to you. That you would build us. Build us into a beautiful palace. Build us into a beautiful door. Lord, in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Pastor, would you like to come?
I'm challenged by the word. And we may think that I want to just get to heaven and that's enough. But don't allow the temporal to distract you from the eternal. One day you'll say, I wish I would have done more. I wish I would have matured. I wish I would have been that door. I wish I would have been that window. I wish I would have produced the gold and the silver and not the hay and stuff. It's interesting, over the past couple of months we've had two speakers by, they both have talked not about us, whether or not we're saved, or not about whether we're not loving God, but what is the depth of our love toward God. And I believe that's where revival begins, when God calls us to a deeper level. I see the time, but I asked my wife if she would just lead us. Can we make this our prayer as we close in a couple chorus, this chorus a couple times? More of you, Jesus. Amen. Not that we just come to seek the hand of God because we want provisions of God. We want healing. We want deliverance. We need God to miraculously work. Brother David said it even in Sunday school this morning. But it's about trusting God. God, I don't come to seek your hand, but I come to seek your face. That's where we mature. And so as we sing this through a couple of times, would you just slip up your hand and say, God, in eternity, I want to be more. I want to have done more than just live by my own appetites. But I wanted to gain a place in the kingdom of God. Wouldn't it be nice if in the kingdom of God we were close to the throne and our residence was close? Amen. I don't want to just be on the outskirts. But I want to know that I've spent my life doing my best, getting close to God. And it starts right here, right now, and for a lifetime. Close your eyes. Lift your voice, but most of all, lift your heart. Lift your hands by doing so. Say, God, I want to seek your face and see you with my life.
Now